you're looking at the world's most dangerous animal. Sharks were responsible for 1,036 deaths between 1916 and 2016. This figure pales in comparison to the daily death toll caused by mosquitoes. Responsible for spreading a long list of diseases including malaria, dengue, and Zika, mosquitoes kill hundreds of thousands of people each year across the globe. Increased urbanization and globalization have helped mosquitoes thrive. But the equation appears incomplete. Scientists are wondering whether climate change will worsen the mosquito problem. Not all mosquitoes are bloodthirsty. Only females come after humans and animals. And that is simply because our blood nourishes their eggs. The most dreaded mosquito-borne disease is malaria, caused by a parasite named Plasmodium. Spreading the parasite to humans are Anopheles mosquitoes. Malaria is responsible for 3 million deaths every year. Africa carries the highest burden of the disease, followed by Southeast Asia, Eastern Mediterranean, Western Pacific, and the Americas. Aedes aegypti and Aedes albopictus, or Asian tiger mosquitoes, are responsible for spreading dengue, chikungunya, Zika, yellow fever, and other viral diseases. The fate of mosquitoes in a given season relies on temperature and rainfall. Here's how. The mosquito life cycle is divided into four stages: egg, larva, pupa, and adult. This entire cycle could take up to 2 weeks to complete, but that could vary. Depending on environmental conditions such as water temperature and food availability, the mosquitoes could either reach the finish line by as early as 4 days or as late as a month. Warm water temperatures might reduce the time that mosquito larvae take to mature, which in turn will lower their exposure to predators like fish or frogs. Mosquitoes are cold-blooded and cannot adjust their body heat as we do, so they prefer warm and wet climates. Cooler conditions can cause injury and even death. Climate change is making the planet warmer while also increasing the number and severity of flooding events. It seems like the mosquitoes have more to gain in a warming world. We don't have definitive proof of climate change's positive impacts on mosquitoes, but researchers think these are some of the ways that climate change could benefit these insects. Their population could swell. They can infiltrate and invade regions that were previously inhospitable to them. Higher evolution rates. The water available due to floods could act as breeding grounds for these insects, boosting their population. One study suggested that Aedes aegypti eggs and adults increased in numbers a month after the flood season. Mosquitoes in the Arctic Circle are growing faster and are emerging earlier than usual, increasing their population in the Northern Hemisphere. The probability of surviving and emerging as adults will increase by more than 50% if temperatures further shoot up by 2 degrees Celsius, a study predicts. In our previous video, we explored why the Arctic Circle is warming 3 times faster than the rest of the world. Please click the link on the top right corner if you haven't watched it yet. The second possibility is that a warming climate could help mosquitoes invade new places. Anopheles mosquitoes and the Plasmodium parasite they carry prosper in the tropics or the torrid zone and the subtropics. The yellow shaded region that you see is where malaria is predominant. The red represents the new areas that are predicted to host Plasmodium falciparum by 2050. Aedes aegypti also have an increased foothold in the tropics. Aedes albopictus, on the other hand, has a higher tolerance for cooler temperatures. They're found in the temperate zones as well. Aedes albopictus was first discovered in Texas, US only in the 1980s. It arrived probably through shipments of scrap tires from Northern Asia. It has now moved to parts of southeastern and central United States. One study predicted that Aedes aegypti will enter new places, posing a threat to 49% of the world's population by 2050. The third possibility. The researchers speculate that rising temperatures could speed up mosquito evolution rates, and this might give rise to new species. When scientists looked at the rate of formation of new species over the past 195 million years, they found a link between increased temperatures and carbon dioxide levels and mosquito evolution rates. So what would happen if evolution rates pick up? We don't know yet, but scientists think controlling new species might prove to be a difficult task. But this doesn't mean all hope is lost. Improving sanitation and addressing poverty could help. There's encouraging work happening on the vaccine front as well. Oxford researchers have developed a vaccine against malaria. Early results showed that the vaccine was 77% effective. Researchers are also testing the suitability of mRNA vaccines in tackling Zika, dengue, and other mosquito-borne illnesses. Finally, we want to remind you all that not all mosquitoes bite. These insects have an essential part to play in the ecosystem. They help pollinate plants. They're also a source of food for other animals. With that, it's time to wrap up. Please don't forget to write to us with your valuable suggestion. We'll be back with another interesting episode of Explained. Do stick around.